What's up, everybody? It's me, GamePsycho123, and I want to apologize for not making a video in a while. There's been an issue in my family, and someone has passed away, and I didn't feel like it was necessary that you all needed to know, but I wanted to explain and tell y'all why I was not active for the past, I think, 6 days. And, I'm really sorry about that. I'm just making this video right now because a lot of people still have trouble making money on GTA Online. And, this is probably the best way that I can think of. First, all you gotta do is you can press pause, come over to online, go to jobs, go to play jobs, and then go to Rockstar Created. Then what you want to do is you want to go to, right now, Stunt Races, because those are double money and double RP, excuse me, I'm sorry. I have done almost every one of them. I've done this one, that one, that one, that one, that one. See, I've done a good amount of them. I don't have very many left to do, but I like doing the motorcycle ones. Specifically, I haven't done that one, and I really want to do that one. See, over here, you can see it says 2x RP, 2x money, and that helps a lot. So what I would suggest is you do those missions until you get enough money to buy a business, like the one that I own. Not one of the big ones, unless you want to get one of the big ones, because you can still do missions for the big ones. But also survivals. I love survivals. I haven't done any of them on this profile, but the Sandy survival and the Rail Yard survival, the Maze Bank, I don't really like the Maze Bank, but the Boneyard survival, that one's also really fun. Like, I love survivals. They take very short amounts of time to do, and they're very easy to do. For me, they are. I've done survivals with just a pistol. But, just do those missions until you get about, I'd say, $800,000 is, I think, the cheapest business that you can buy. And then, I own a cocaine business, but what you need to do is you need to get a motorcycle club. And you don't even need a business with the motorcycle club. You can just have a motorcycle club and do missions. You don't need a business. I was saying like $800 to get a business, but you don't need to even get the business, because as long as you get the motorcycle club, that's what I'm in right now. I think it costs about $200,000, and it's very cheap. The one that I own was one of the better ones, I think. And you can upgrade it as well. I just don't like to... Yeah, I don't like to, and right now I can't access the network because I'm not in a public lobby. See, join public session. I was going to show you what it does. What that does is it shows you the prices for the stuff that you can do. Right now you see I've got bricks of cocaine. That means that I own a cocaine business. I bought a cocaine business for about, I think, $900,000. And now if you come in here, you can see I've got cocaine and I've got money. I have money and cocaine. That is the amount of sales. Like, the more sales that you do, the more cocaine that shows up in your building. And the more missions, those things on the wall that you do, the more money you get. And this is where the money comes in. This is where you get quick and easy money. You do these. This mission... It's very easy for me to do, so I'm just gonna select that one, and then we're gonna go and do it. Retrieve the product. I'm not gonna spoil it or anything, but I already know what to do. I've done every mission that you can do for them, and then you can just redo them. And they're very simple missions. Oh crap, there it is.
Cool, you gonna get...
Okay, he's just telling me where to go. I need to go to the catfish view. I haven't done this, actually. I've done one of these. Actually, I've done two of these missions over there, but not over here. So I don't know what's going to happen over here, but hopefully it's the same idea. So we're just real quick. See how much money I have right now? I have gained, I've gotten 339,000. Wait, $365,000 from doing missions in my business back there. Just from doing missions. And I've gotten that in the past 2 days. I did these jobs for an hour. Because once you clear the board, you gotta wait to get more. Or I think once you completely clear the wall, more show up. But if you can't clear the wall, like right now I can't because I need more than one player to do one of those missions, I have to wait, I think, 10 to 15 minutes. I'm not sure though. Maybe an hour. I don't know. And they give you half an hour to do these missions. Down there, it says 28 seconds right now. That's, it started out as 15. I mean, not 15. It says 28 minutes. It started out as 30. You get half an hour to do a mission. And it's very, very easy to do these missions. And this is the thing. This is an invite-only lobby. It's not a public session. And I showed you that earlier because it said that I had to do this without being in a public set. I couldn't get on the computer without being in a public session. So, well, okay, what we're going to do is we need to go into this part right here. So we're just going to land, right? Get the product from the ballers. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to go over here. Land up here and then snipe them. I'm gonna land over. You know what? Who cares? The product is on the boat. Get to it. Okay, how am I gonna do this? I'm gonna have to get really lucky here. I gotta shoot the dude that's driving that thing. Hey, bro. I have not done this mission yet, so that's why I look like a complete noob right now. I'm just gonna land on it. Oh, wait a minute. If they're just gonna do circles, I'll just land over here and snipe them. Oh, crap. Yeah, I'm just gonna land over here and snipe them. Oops. Hope the helicopter can survive this. Sea sharks, huh? Okay, how about I just do this? Dang it. Got it. That was easy. A lot easier than I was expecting. Wow. Okay then. Maybe I can land just on it and get it. Like, that'd be awesome. Okay, let's see if we can do it, everybody. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, come on. Are you still alive? Okay, go down, 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 down. I got it. Oh, I did it. I collected the product. Awesome. And I didn't destroy the helicopter completely. Completely. Oh, that lighthouse is so cool. This helicopter's not gonna make it. Hopefully it does. Oh, the military base is right over here. Oh, people are chasing after me. Good thing I'm in a helicopter. Haha. Oh, crap, crap, crap. Don't celebrate too soon, please. It took me 6 minutes to do that, and that was only because I didn't... I was being stupid. See, a mission like that where they're going to get onto an escape vehicle, you should land and, like, snipe them before they can get in the vehicle. That's what I was gonna do, because I've done missions similar to that one where they do escape on a boat. Actually, I think it was a heist. I don't know. It was something to do with the Mallard. But not the Mallard. The floating plane. Jesus. Can't think of words. I'm sorry, y'all. But, yeah. So, I'm just making this video, anyways, to tell you all what's happening, and stuff like that. And stuff. But, what the heck? That just spawned there, didn't it? That's sick. We made 13,000 off of that, and I feel like after the trouble I went through, I should have made more off of it, but I did make a good amount of RP. See? Our reputation. Yeah, RP. That's a homeless camp. And that's not actually it.
Okay, I don't care how, but...
Shut up now. Alright, we've got... $280,000 with $15,564 in the bank. I mean, in our wallet. And $280,240 in our bank. We need to get more. I want to get more than $300,000. Come on. Can we at least make it over this freaking mountain? Thank you. Jesus, this helicopter's not going to make it far. Oh, there's a landing strip right here. We can go down here and pick up the helicopter. I need to buy a buzzard. That's going to be the greatest investment ever. That's something you definitely need to do, is purchase a buzzard. For real, that's the greatest investment ever. Wow, there's not a helicopter here. Dang. That's sad. Oh, Jesus. Cargo Bob scared the crap out of me. I'm not taking a Cargo Bob, I can tell you that. That's a bit of a waste, to be honest, because I don't really... Oh, great. I don't think I can get around this. Well, look at Stupid over here. Parking a helicopter in front of a plane that he's about to fly. Okay, yeah, we could do it. Make it over this tree here, turn and go straight over the water. Perfect. Look at the lights, they're pretty cool. Ain't they? I freaking love them, man. Lights are so cool in this game. I would use this plane. Good lord, I'm stupid. I would use this plane to do missions, but it's really hard to take off with. Oh! Okay. Hey, did you see my bike? The plane bounced over my bike. Where did I just spawn? Holy crap. Whoa, hello, flaming plane. And my bike. There's my bike. Oh my lord, my bike is still alive. It bounced over my bike. Holy crap. That's so cool. See it? It's right here. Oh, snap. It's alive. Alive. Aw, that helicopter despawned. Totally not cool, bro. Totally not cool. Doing these missions is so much easier with a helicopter. Because most of them are, you go to this area, do this thing, and then come back. Like, pretty much the main missions that you get the most money from there's one, it's called POW, and you have to go rescue one of your clients from the police. And, yeah, you get like over 20,000 for that. Another freaking Cargo Bob, are you serious? Okay, yes, they're fun to play around with, but really, I don't need one right now. Whatever, man. Helicopter's a helicopter. Even if it is a freaking carrying helicopter, the bit on the back, it's meant for carrying supplies and troops. You can tell because it's got two blades. They have two blades, so it can carry stuff. You know, because I don't know very many helicopters with one blade and not with all this body and one blade that can carry a military 6-ton truck. Man, this flight is taking forever. Although, if I need to do a mission where I've got to fill up a truck with something and then take that truck somewhere, I've got you covered. I could just take the truck using this thing instead of having to actually go somewhere. I need to find out how I can get up on here, because landing up here would be very helpful. See? Oops. Let's land it right here. Okay. That was good. New adversary mode available. Accept Martin's invite. Usually there's a featured adversary mode, but they're doing, I think, featured stunt races right now. And that's what you can make a good amount of money off of. Look at my motorcycles. Y'all already seen the green one. This is my Nightblade. It's purple and green. This is my Daemon. I call it a demon. It's white and black. And then this is my Nemesis. And it's black and white. Oh, that's an actual heist. Like, that's the actual heist. Prison Break. I could get 40... Wait. Prison Break gives you 100 grand, actually. Should I? I should. I'm going to. Or wait. I'm gonna go and check this real quick. Yeah, okay, here we go. It reset. Okay, can't do that one, can't do that one. Oh. Okay, I can't do any of those. There needs to be a switch. Yeah, there needs to be like a switch thing. Members marked for death, 3. Okay, let's see if that kid still has the invite out. Okay, let's join and do this. Okay. And the session I'm trying to join is currently full. Do you want to join a queue? No. Well, that was fun. Fun while it lasted. Am I in a public lobby? Nope. Oh yeah. I know what I'm gonna do. Since I went to a different lobby type thing and came back, it should have changed. What in the world? It did. Gun running. Okay, hopefully the helicopter stayed, because that would be helpful, very helpful. Crap, it didn't. Okay. Oh, you gotta be kidding. Yeah, I'm stealing a helicopter. That is ridiculous. That is very far away. Alright. That's ridiculous. It's all the way over there, and then they want me to drive all the way over there, steal the stuff, and then drive it all the way back as well. That's a little stupid. Just a little. Okay, a lot. It's very stupid. Wheelie! Oh, a touchdown. Plane and a helicopter. It's not a bad helicopter, it's a Maverick. Mavericks are actually kind of nice. They got two blades, the police helicopters got three blades, the cargo bobs, they got like eight blades, and then the Froggers have four blades, I think. Actually, the Froggers might have one blade. I have no idea. And then those really fancy helicopters that are with the like the yachts and stuff. I'm pretty sure I've seen one that had five blades. But yeah, the more blades means more air pushed down, which means that the helicopter is propelled quicker. So like a helicopter with more blades means it'll go faster. That's why this one looks like it's going so slow, because it is going slow. Or, wait a minute, it might be the other way around. Less blades, faster spinning. Yeah, that might be how it is. Less blades, like, thicker, like, tilt. That means that more air can be propelled. I think. I have no idea. Okay, looks like we are coming up on the stuff, because the bridge over there goes to the, it goes to the docks. See? There's the water, the airport is right there. That bridge goes to the docks, like I was saying. And that 15,564 is about to change. Alright, let's go down. Okay, there it is. Oh, dang. Okay. Let's go over here. Land it right here. I can't land. Okay. What the heck is he pointing at? Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, there's a guy over there to the right, too. Let's get this headshot. Crap, I missed. Dang it. Really now? I had to reload, are you serious? Are they all dead? Okay then. I was hoping for a bit of a smoother thing. If I had the 50 caliber sniper rifle, the heavy sniper, I could have killed them all. We killed all three of those people in one shot. I've got to load it into this truck, don't I? I do. This ought to be fun. I haven't driven one of these yet. And I've got to run into the thing and around all this garbage. Yippee. Okay. Luckily, I don't have to worry about anyone chasing after me while I'm loading the stuff up, because that's not in this. That isn't in this. Okay, it took me 6 minutes to fly over here and shoot all those people, and that's flying. Now I'm going to have to drive a truck all the way back. So that's going to take at least 10 to 14 minutes. This ought to be fun. Now get in the truck. I haven't driven one of these yet. I'm vapid car core tender. Oh, this truck is actually nice. Wish this door would close. Holy crap, this door is freaking sturdy. Jesus. Okay, now at least now the door isn't on. Like, at least now it's not open. Wow, this truck is really fast. Holy crap. Okay. And it can drive over stuff. I need to buy one of these. And I'm pretty sure it's armored as well. I need this truck. Wow. I am in love with this truck. The steering is amazing. Look at that. I'm even able to pull out of... That's what she said. I'm sorry. That is a bad joke. I'm even able to pull out of a hydroplane. And if you can find you a vehicle that's able to pull out of a hydroplane, you need to get that vehicle. Because hydroplanes are a pretty bad thing in vehicles like this. In big trucks like this, the last thing that you want to do is hydroplane around a turn and flip. Because if a big truck like this flips and you end up out of it and like it lands on you, you're losing a body part. Or your life. Same with that kind of truck. I know a guy who was driving a truck and he hit, I don't remember what he hit, but he did the same thing I just did, but wrapped around a telephone pole. And, not literally wrapped around it, it was more like he hit it with his rear end, spun around, flew out of the cab, and then it landed on him, crippling him from the waist down. Actually, no, I think it just broke both his legs. Like, permanently broke. No, he was crippled, that's what it was. Like, nerve damage to his spine. Holy crap! Oh, shoot. Okay, here we go. I love how I'm just driving with a big thing full of illegal weapons in the bed of my truck. I need to find out how much this truck costs. Vapid Contender. Okay, I thought it was Core, because that R, I mean that N looks like an R. That's not how I did my, that's not how you do a cursive N. A cursive N has two humps. But that's not really cursive. That's more like words are connected, like letters are connected together to be fancy. Okay, so it actually only took me 4 minutes to get down here. Which is amazing. Actually, it took me almost less than 4 minutes. Because as you can tell, there's still quite a, there's 30 seconds until, 20, 30, nice. Okay, there we go. I just made $19,500 off of that. And I want back in this. Let me back in this, please. And look how much RP I got up there. It's not bad. Not bad at all. See? And he called. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here. Open this up. Put my money in the bank. And we now have over 300,000. Boom. See? And, like, it. When I started doing the missions, I only had 240,000. I did two missions, and now I have over 300,000. So, like, right there gives you 40,000 over two missions. And each mission takes at least 10 minutes. And it gives you 30. So if you do mess up, this music. Okay, for real. Oh, I still died. See the blood stain on the ground? That's funny. Okay, where am I? Are you kidding me? That spawned me way out. Holy crap. We're gonna go to the travel and transport. Wow. Okay, Benny's. I forgot that you're here now. Huh. Oh, the Hakuchu drag racing motorcycle. The Ocelot Lynx, the BF Raptor. Holy crap. Okay. That's 648,000. I just need 88,000 more. We're gonna sort by price. That's free. The Nagasaki. Hey, we bombed them. The Fitzer Comet. The Vapid Hot Knife. I'm very happy that they made the Hot Knife and the Chameleon and the Carbon available to people who didn't pre-order the game. Because originally they were only available to people who pre-ordered. That's worth $9,000, but on here it costs $149,000 to $334,000. Are you serious? The Feltzer is one of my favorite sports cars. The Virgo is a pretty nice car. So is the Chino. That's a upgraded baller. It's got armor on it, I think. The Pegasi, Infernus, and the Vaca. Where is the Vaca? Oh, the Turismo. Oh, the Nightshade. That's a beautiful car. The Cheetah. The Brawler. Oh, I love that thing. Driving that around was fun. There's the Zentorno. Where is the Vaca? It looks kind of like the Zentorno. There it is. 240,000. The Windsor. Pretty bad car. The Z-Type. That thing used to cost 10 million, I think. True Fade Adar only takes 1,000, but the Adar is, like, not the fastest car anymore. Like, the Tempesta is faster than the Adar. Trust me, I know. I've been racing a lot. Oh, that's on sale? That's not that bad of a sale. I'm kidding, that's a horrible sale. Now, that's a sale. I'm kidding, these are both less... These are both like minus 400,000. The Tyrus and the X80 Proto. Oh, that's a nice vehicle right there. Okay. We're gonna back out of here. Let's check out Elitist real quick. That. It's got five. See? One, two, three, five. And five. This one's got four. That one's got four. I used to own that. It's awesome. It takes like seven more hits than this. I own that as well. I own this. I own, look, Maverick, the Frogger, it's got four, just like I said. The Annihilator, it's got four. And the Titan, it's got 16. We're gonna go to the War Stock and check it out. Oh, yes. That is the vehicle that I want. And that is an amphibious vehicle. It can go from water to land. Wastelander. See, this is what I'm thinking. Since they're adding really cool vehicles like these and stuff, I'm thinking that they're going to add zombies. Because you know what people do. They have the zombie mods and stuff like that. Zombie mods are... You can't make a mod for a game without... without the coding. Okay, and so I mean you can, but trust me, it takes a long time to code an entire thing of code for something. I know. Okay, I do this kind of stuff. Look at that. That's funny. Motorcycles are definitely my favorite thing to mess around with. The Vortex, 356,000. Good Jesus. But the Vortex is one of the fastest that I've driven, actually. The Defiler and the Vortex are pretty much the same, but the Vortex is faster than the Defiler. And then there's a new racing Street Blazer, which is pretty sick. I was doing a race, and I seen a person spawn in on this. It was sad. And I also saw someone driving that, and they stomped me. And these are awesome rally cars. Oh my god. Freaking love rally cars. Here it is. The Contender. The Vapid Contender. 250,000. Oh. The classy burger shot. Oh, that's sick. This one's really sick. Oh, wow. It's 995,000. I've had that. I've had this. This was actually a pretty okay vehicle. Armored Karuma, 525,000. That's what I'm trying to get. No, wait a minute. That's not what I'm trying to get. That's what I'm trying to get. That is a Skyline. Okay. A Skyline. The GT8 Pegasi FCR1000. I might buy that just to upgrade it. Oh, and then there's also the Principe Diabolus. And then there's the Nero in the Comet. The Comet's okay. I like the Comet. Ah, here it is. That is the upgraded version. That's the stock vehicle. And then upgraded version. Customized example. It's retrofitted and it is just beautiful. Like, I'm serious. I've been saving up for that for so long. It cost, I think, 900,000 to retrofit it. Oh, I have one of those at my house. And the Banshees are pretty sick as well. Okay. Anyways, like I was saying, I wanted to make this video to apologize to everybody for not making a video for 6 days. But there has been a death in my family, and so the next 2 days I'm not going to make a video either. And maybe a day or two after that as well. I will try, though. Wow, that's not blown up. I thought I just blew up a How did that motorcycle survive? For real? Really? Okay, we're going to see how much we can sell this for while we talk here. Thank y'all for coming out and watching my stuff. I hope you do enjoy my content. If you don't, please, like, tell me that you don't enjoy the content that I'm doing. $800, wow, okay. I just spent more to fix the stupid thing. I do want you to tell me anything I can do to make better content. Because, I mean, I don't want to make annoying, like, boring content that nobody wants to watch. Sorry, I keep saying, I'm losing my train of thought. I'm trying to text and play at the same time. Not a smart idea. So, thank y'all for coming out and watching. Definitely drop a like if you enjoyed this video. I'm sorry it might have been a little long. It's not bad. I just wanted to get across my point and show you all how to make some easy money. Like, for real, I've done those, missions. I did the racing stunt missions. I did those for an hour and I came out with almost $200,000, which is, between you and me guys, that's really good amount of money for doing an hour worth of racing, especially because racing is the most fun thing to do in this game, other than take a truck like this and do something like this. Like, you can't tell me that that's not fun to do, because it's freaking hilarious to do something like this. Whee! Boom! Nailed it. Oh, I just got a bounty for this, too. How much did I get? How much money did this dude just spend on me? $3,000 isn't that bad, to be honest. I usually, whenever I get a bounty in a public session, I'll message someone and be like, hey, you want my bounty? But, yeah. Thank you all for watching. Drop a like down below. Leave a comment down in the section down there, that top deal thingy. And if you're not subscribed already, definitely hit the subscribe button, because you don't want to miss out on any more of my amazing truck flipping money tactics. Money making tactics is probably the best way to put it, because, like, that is the best way to get money right now. Like, if you're a low level, when you start up the game, look down at the bottom. It'll say online, and then it'll say, what? That's right in my transmission. That's not good. It'll say, press R1 to do, the whatever mission is giving extra money for at the moment. Usually it's like featured adversary modes. I cannot think of the words today. Good lord. But yeah, so you can press R1 and it'll load you straight into one of those missions, or you can press square and go straight to online, or you can let it load and then go and press pause, go over to online and go to invite only session, and you can do missions like this. I was level 52 2 days ago, so, and I did, in 2 days, I've done about 4 hours of racing and maybe an hour worth of doing these missions, and these missions pay almost $20,000 a mission. So 5 of these missions gives you $100,000. It's a very, very, very good investment, and I've already, like, definitely made more money than I spent on this building. I will show you how much money I've made, actually. And we can't do any missions yet, because that one, 9/10 of the law, it says you do not have enough members. Clubhouse contract earnings, $396,500, and that's a picture of a butt. Hello. Oh, okay, that, there's a picture right there, and it's a picture of a girl. Okay. Rival presidents killed, 70. Motorcycle club deaths, 70. Motorcycle club kills, 58. Rival CEO and VIPs killed, 9. Bike melee kills. I do have bike melee kills, actually. Miniguns, ET. Minigun times 1. Assault rifle, SMG. Ammo, assault rifle. Ammo, 9mm. I don't know what that means, but okay. And we got a card for Benny's. We've done, look, clubhouse contracts completed. 23, and we've gotten $396,500. When you first start out, they don't pay like $20,000. They will pay like $5,000 to $10,000 to $15,000. Don't quote me on that though, because I don't know. But 396, that means like it takes less than 10 missions to get 100,000. That's about 7, I'd say. Because we're just about, it's a, yeah, like I said, 5 missions gives you about 100. Because look, 20 and then almost 400,000, that means 5 times 4 makes 20. And then 5 times 100 makes, wait a minute, 4 times 5 makes 20. And then 4 times 100 makes 400. Sorry, not thinking of math at the moment. But yeah, thank you all for watching.